Since the war in Ukraine started, many new tactics have been implemented. Drone warfare, especially the widespread use of small drones, has been a key facet of this conflict. For years, electronic warfare has been one of the most effective defenses against cheap drones on the battlefield. But now, both parties appear to be extensively deploying drones tethered to fiber-optic cables that are immune to jamming. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why fiber-optic drones have been a disruptive force in the Ukraine war. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Drones have become one of the most decisive technologies on the battlefield. From cheap commercial quadcopters dropping grenades, to Turkish Bayraktar TB2s, to Iranian Shahed suicide drones, unmanned systems are everywhere. In July 2025, Russia fired more than 6,000 drones into Ukraine in that month alone, a record high. For the period June through September 2025, monthly averages for Shahed-type drones hovered around 5,400 launches per month. But this drone revolution has also sparked an electronic warfare arms race. Both Ukraine and Russia have invested heavily in jamming systems. Powerful radio frequency emitters designed to block GPS, disrupt control links, and make drones crash. A core target is satellite navigation. Civil GNSS, Global Navigation and Satellite System, signals operate on well-known carrier frequencies. L1 equals 1,575.42 megahertz, L2 approximately 1,227.60 megahertz, L5 approximately 1,176.45 megahertz, and low-cost drones rely on those civilian channels. Relatively modest continuous wave jammers, tens to hundreds of watts ERP, can deny position fixes across kilometers. High-power systems using directional antennas or airborne platforms can extend that to tens of kilometers. Modern electronic warfare is more than brute force noise. Techniques include meaconing, rebroadcasting delayed GNSS signals, repeater attacks, adaptive and cognitive jamming, systems that detect an enemy, frequency plan and tailor interference, and waveform deception, transmitting signals that mimic legitimate telemetry but carry false data. Both sides deploy a layered mix of electronic warfare kit. That includes vehicle-mounted wideband jamming trucks and improvised setups for local denial, airborne jammers on electronic attack aircraft or helicopters, and small tactical systems for convoy or forward area protection. For a time this worked, cheap drones were often forced down, the expensive ones were blinded. But Russia made an ingenious change. They started fielding huge amounts of fiber-optic tethered drones, machines connected directly to their operators by a spool of cable instead of radio signals. Traditional drones rely on radio frequency communication for both control and video transmission. That makes them vulnerable. If you jam the frequency, the drone is useless. But a fiber-optic drone uses a physical cable to send commands and transmit video. Imagine a kite, except instead of a string, it has a lightweight spool of optical fiber unrolling behind it as it flies. Fiber-optic tethering gives drones several advantages. With no radio link, they are immune to electronic warfare jamming since the control connection is physically hardwired between operator and drone. The cable also enables the secure transmission of high-bandwidth video over tens of kilometers with minimal delay. Further, in some designs, power can be delivered through the tether, greatly extending endurance compared to battery-only systems. While fiber-optic guidance has long been used in precision weapons such as the US TOW-2B and the Israeli Spike missile, applying the concept to drones is a novel development, one that Russia started weaponizing in Ukraine. With no radio link, fiber-optic drones emit no electronic signature and hence are very hard to detect. Russian troops are equipping small quadcopters and larger multi-rotor drones with fiber-optic tethers. Some of these drones are then packed with explosives, essentially becoming flying IEDs. These carry out ambush attacks by flying low and quietly, guided through the secure cable, before diving into vehicles such as infantry transports or supply trucks and detonating. Other than this suicide tactics, these drones are also being used for precision strikes. They hover above trenches or dugouts and drop explosive charges with accuracy. Since they cannot be jammed, Ukrainian troops must rely on physically spotting and shooting them down, a much harder task. Soldiers describe these unjammable systems as ghost machines that appear suddenly and unpredictably, amplifying their psychological impact. These drones have already made a serious impact, from their role in Russia's recapture of Kursk Oblast in April to the devastation of logistics all across the front line. Ukraine is also deploying fiber-optic drones, though not yet on the same scale as Russia. They are still a minority of Ukraine's drone arsenal, but their deployment is growing in number, capability, and range. Fiber-optic drones are not a perfect weapon. Despite their advantages, fiber-optic drones have notable drawbacks. Their range is limited by the length of the cable, typically 5 to 10 miles, 8 to 16 kilometers. The tether itself is physically vulnerable, prone to snagging on obstacles or being cut by gunfire. Add to this the fact that operators must manage bulky spools of cable during deployment, which reduces mobility and requires setup time. While not a battlefield game changer on their own, these drones still represent a dangerous and disruptive addition to the arsenal of both parties. Ukraine has experimented with interceptor drones equipped with nets or explosive charges to destroy enemy drones mid-air. Still, every adaptation costs time and resources, and Russia's innovation shows how quickly warfare is evolving. Russia's fiber-optic, unjammable drones may not be high-tech hypersonic missiles or stealth jets, but they show how innovation at the small scale can have an outsized impact. Russian forces have created a weapon that is cheap, flexible, and extremely difficult to counter. For Ukraine, this presented another challenge, and they are responding well. Reports suggest it scaled up production by early 2025 and has closed the gap to a large extent. For the rest of the world, it's a warning. The next era of drone warfare will not be fought only in the electromagnetic spectrum.